Welcome to the Tudor Christmas Cook Along. We're going to be cooking a recipe called Cormory, a late 15th century recipe made with pork. So the first thing we're going to need is some pork. The first thing to do on the recipe is to take off any fat that you happen to have on it. You don't really need that in the recipe. And then put that to one side for a moment. For the marinade, we're going to need a bowl, some wine, and some spices. The spices we have are caraway, coriander, and pepper. Well, I've got mine whole, so I'm going to have to make them smaller before we can use them. If you can find them ready powdered, that's fine. It's about half a teaspoonful of each is all you need. The recipe says to make them really small, so if you have powdered already, it will just make this bit a bit quicker. And when you've made them nice and small, you add that to your wine, a little bit of salt, and some garlic. I'm just going to process the garlic up. If you make the garlic nice and small, it'll add much more pungency to your recipe. There we go. Another one of those. Now, it shouldn't take me a second just to wind these up. And there we are, garlic. Just pop those in the marinade. Give that a bit of a swish around, and then in go. Next thing, I suppose, is to make sure the marinade goes right the way through, and the recipe says to spike it, which we'll do, and then pop that in. And then leave that for overnight, if you can. Just make a really good marinade. Quite often it's best to put it into the freezer for as long as you need. Okay, so with a good hot pan, you take your steak, your pork loin, pop it in there. Shouldn't take very long, a few minutes on each side, and that way it's a very, very quick dish to cook. Now, this recipe was originally a roasting recipe for an entire loin, but using the steaks that are very readily available in the supermarket makes it that much easier. Okay, that's cooked now and it's ready for service. Doesn't take very long, and if you've got a really hot pan, you can get some nice caramelization on the steak before it goes in. If you want to, you can use some of the marinade, reduce it down to create a little bit of a sauce to go with it. Just reducing that down a bit and deglazing the pan at the same time. And there we are, Cormory.